perfect match. So if you've all got this great tasting clothes, of course he will propose. Dear Al, honey, mazel tov, for teachers, pick it up. Bring that ring back and show it to me. Poor Kevin, the princess cut. Are you psyched or what? I just wish I could be there to see. When he gets
to come from the water. Tonight's just perfect.
No, you're perfect.
No, you are.
No, you.
No, you.
You.
You. Okay, I've been irritating myself.
Elle, I just want you to know how happy you've made me. Every guy dreams of finding a girl who looks just like you. We both know why we're here. I see it in your eyes. I guess it calms my fear to know it's not a surprise. I thought one of you, looking like a dream come true, would leave me speechless like you always do. But now we're wide awake. We got some plans to make. Let's take some action, baby. So baby, give me your hand. I've got some plans to make you. I've got my future all planned. It's time to get serious. Time to get serious with you.
Never thought that I...
Honey, I'm not finished.
Ooh, sorry.
Since I was 2 or 3, my life was planned out neat. I'd get my lottery,
yeah.
And then with my ascendancy, a big white house that could
use
all the amenities.
Yeah.
3 kids at least, just like the Kennedys. Here's where our lives begin. But just where do you fit in?
Fit in.
Let me break it down now, baby. Baby, that's why you and I should break up.
Yes, baby, I'll give you my hand. You go, what? You're breaking up with me? But I thought you were proposing.
I did talk to my parents about it, Pooh Bear, and they expect a lot from me. I'm going to Harvard Law School. My brother's at Yale Law, so is his new wife, and she's a Vanderbilt, for Christ's sake.
So what, am I not good enough for you, Warner? I'm from Malibu, I'm not exactly trailer trash here. Richard Simmons is our neighbor.
If I'm gonna be a senator, by the time I'm 30, I'm gonna need somebody that's serious. Less of a man, more of a Jackie. Serious. Somebody classy enough. Okay, that came out wrong. Baby, let's both be strong. I mean, we've gone all along.
Shut up. What does that mean? I'm not a Jackie. I'm not serious, but I'm seriously in love with you.
Baby, my future's all planned. I've got some dreams to make true. I thought that you'd understand. It's time to get serious. Time to get serious. Check, please.
Style and your favorite, the one that you love, Elle magazine.
Thanks, Pilar. But it's going to take more than Elle and Life and Style to bring me back from the shame spiral.
Then, honey, you're just going to have to hold on because the new Cosmo doesn't come out until next week.
What? Do not tell me Croc's back in.
No. First, it's Warner's brother, Peyton Huntington IV, pictures from his wedding. Look.
Muffy Vanderbilt?
Muffy!
Wait a sec. This is the type of girl Warner wants. Someone serious. Someone lawyerly. Someone who wears black even when nobody's dead.
Ew.
Girls, I have a completely brilliant plan. What do you want? Water, what do you want? It means, but you need to see me in a brand new domain. Everything, water in a different set. You will see your daddy all of this. That's a crane. I'll be generous, Harvard, with a book in my hand. Big sturdy book, big pretty book. Full of words I'll understand and write. There is where you sing it to. Water, but the fog is right in front of you. What you want? What you want, right here. What you want is right in front of you, front of you. What you want is clear. What you want, right here. Right in front of you, front of you. Step one, he's off to Harvard Law. So I get in there too.
Step two,
make Warner reassess. Impress him with my high IQ.
Step three,
you throw a great big wedding.
And invite us up new.
I have a 4.0 average.
That is merchandising. What did you do
with
this?
Love, I'm going there for love.
What do you want? You want to drive it off the road?
acceptance to Adam Cohen and Sandeep Matalagon.
Okay.
And now Miss Elle Woods, who was kind enough to send in a headshot.
Fine?
Apparently.
Just here, she has a 4.0 average.
Yes, in fashion merchandising.
She has a 175 in her LSATs. And there's also a recommendation letter from Oprah Winfrey.
Now, I'm not arguing that Miss Woods is entirely unqualified, but look at her. Is that a face of harm and law?
Well, I got you.
Excuse me.
Usually made here for reasons, multiculturalism.
Gentlemen, please, please, this is harm and law, not match.com. Oh, what a shame. She didn't bother to send in a personal essay.
Is this her personal essay?
Represent. Welcome to the hell of laws of Harvard Law. Let's just go around and
Share a bit about yourself.
Aaron Schultz, I'm a Fulbright and a Rhodes. I'm a financial software code. But that's a challenge I don't grow. How many odds can a one man know? Some say that I'm a pompous creep. Somehow I don't lose that much sleep. Why the wind was frosty? All of the perfect place for food.
Rich, impressive, good to know.
Welcome to Marvin.
What's up?
Yo!
Study for one of another time. But you, they call me your majesty.
My country. My world was born, but then I feel because of stupid Kudeta. So here I learned I made new friends, and soon returned in bulletproof Mercedes Benz.
Pretty impressive, good to know.
Impressive.
But now I'm on the legal track because our country's out of whack and only women have the guts to go and take it back. We'll make the government clean and get more people voting green and really stick it to the fellas in the war machine.
Oh my god. I love your talk. It's so critique. So, Snaps, how's that for you guys for staying Harvard Law?
I know Woods. And this is Bruiser Woods.
Eat it.
Oh my god, we both have names to start with an E.
Oh my god, we're practically twins.
We're just going around the circle. Tell us something about yourself.
Me?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I'm a Gemini with a double Capricorn moon. I have a bachelor's degree from UCLA, where I was Sig F sweetheart, president of Delta Mu sorority, and I founded a charity, Shop for a Cause.
Oh.
And last week at Fred Segal, I talked Beyonce out of buying this truly heinous cable knit tube top. Whoever said tangerine is the new pink is seriously disturbed.
I did not know that.
Does anyone know where I can find Criminal Law 101 with Professor Callahan and Warner Hudson III?
Well, we're all about to go there, so I'm sure somebody will be happy to show you. It's over there, Hauser. Second building to the left. And I don't think dogs are exactly allowed in class.
No, Bruiser is not a dog. Bruiser's family. But you're right. He'll be happier in my room anyway. Bruiser loves Glee. See you later.
See ya.
Right hand up.
I was a natural speed.
I did not do it on a stupid calculating with me. Do you remember the old girl who was out of a tree? Hard in the perfect place.
All that pink you're wearing, is that even legal?
Pink is my signature color.
So I gather.
All right, everyone, take your seats. Callahan should be here in any second. You know, 3 years ago, I was sitting right where you guys were sitting, and I heard the same rumors I'm sure you've heard, too. Callahan's ruthless, he bathes in the blood of sheep, blah, blah, blah. Only partially true. What you really need to know is that
you have the rights to remain silent. Anything you say will be used against you. Now, when you choose a law career, the moment you embark, there is that joke you're about to hear. A lawyer is a shark. Ignore that. It's simplistic and it's dumb. Only some of you will turn out sharks. Just some. The rest are chum.
kids, it's time you faced. Law school is a waste. Oh yes, unless you acquire a taste for blood in the water. Dark and red and raw, you're nothing until the thrill of the guilt becomes your only law. Mr. Schultz, hypothetical question. Would you be willing to defend the following banker accused of fraud? A kind old grandma took her savings and she sent it. Offered her client all she saved since she was born. Those guidance to invest it when he spent it on prostitutes, heroin, and more. Wrong! This was a win unless you're lazy. Grandma's brochures have some actual legal aid. But are on the standard color old and crazy. Your guy goes free and he can even get you laid. Look for the blood in the water. Read your Thomas Hobbes. Only spot the snobs. For quarrel with the morally dubious jobs and blood in the water. Your scruples are a flaw. Miss Oops, another hypothetical. Would you be willing to defend the next crime we have on our list? Okay. Say they offer you a bundle for defending. A famous hitman from the mafia elite. Seems he misses your brain, shot a nun and drove away, running over three cute puppies in the street.
What? You think I wouldn't defend it just because of a typical man?
A typical man. You lesbians think you're so tough. Oh, I fear my comments have offended. Hard to argue when you're too mad to speak. Your employment will be very quickly ended once they see how your emotions make you weak. So what's my point? I run a $1 billion law firm. And I hire 4 new interns every year. And from this class, I will select loyal jocks whom I respect, and those 4 will have a guaranteed career. Do you follow me? So I wanna see what?
Blood in the water.
Exactly. Let the games begin. 4 of you will win. But just those 4 with a dorsal fin and blood in the water. So by death, scratch and claw, yes, miss.
Wood, L. Wood.
Seems somewhat better than what he's talking. Would you summarize the case of State of Indiana v. Hearn from your assigned reading, please?
Oh, no, I wanted to answer the puppy question.
But I'm asking you about the assigned reading, Miss Woods.
Okay, seriously, who was assigned to reading for the first day?
You have guts, Miss Woods. You do have guts. Miss Kensington. Say you teach a class at Harvard Law School, a position that you'll just be proud about. But a girl on whom you call hasn't read the case at all. Should you let it go, or?
No, I throw her out.
All right, then. You heard your classmates. You have just been killed. She cut your throat, so grab your coat. Yes, you got guts, but now there's spill your blood in the water. So would you please withdraw? And if you return, be ready to learn. Or is it unfair? Oh wait, I don't care. That's just the life in life and in school. With fear and shock and awe, you're nothing until the thrill of the kill becomes your only love, your only love, your only
Listen,
I was kicked out of class once first year, too. It's terrible, but trust me, your law career is not over.
Law career? So not the problem. Listen, I need to get back into class with Warner. Can you help me?
Yeah, just come back tomorrow and make sure you've done your reading.
Oh, excuse me. Why would you do that to another girl?
Do what?
Because girls have to stick together. We can't try to make each other look good by making each other look bad.
I didn't make you look bad. You just weren't prepared. Try opening a law book, but I should warn you. They don't come with pictures.
So I'll give you ladies a moment then.
Aren't there girls going wild somewhere without you?
Hey!
Oh, Warner, thank God you're here. Sorry for what?
Warner, is there something you'd like to share with Elle?
Do you know her?
Yes. Elle. Vivian and I went to boarding school together. And now she's my girlfriend.
I'm sorry, I just hallucinated. What did you say?
He said I'm his girlfriend.
Girlfriend? Margo, Serena, Pilar, girls, what are you doing here?
Honey, this is a tragedy, and every tragedy needs a Greek chorus.
Greek chorus!
Elle, we are here to help.
Yes, but we're not actually here. No, we're just in your head.
Honey, what you crying at? You're not losing him to that.
Shake, 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 shake,
on here. Back it up. Phil, Paulette's listening.
Okay, so I'm Elle Woods, and I came out all the way from Harvard Law School.
That's a good school.
I know, right? Anyways, I did it to follow my one true love, Warner. And now he's dating an evil preppy.
So what's she got that you don't got? Three boobs?
She's serious.
Seriously, she got three boobs?
No, she's a constipated polo shirt with a mousy brown ball. Apparently, that's what Warner wants, so you have to make me a brunette.
Whoa. Do you know the number one reason behind all bad hair decisions? Love. You lost without your love, your heart is on the floor. Well, I can help you, I've been there before. When I need to relax, I just put on some tracks. From this CD, I bought for the store. Isn't that relaxing? It's called Captain Boots! When I'm lonely or feeling dejected, I play this. And it never fails. I pretend like I'm in Ireland with Enya and the whales. When my telephone gets disconnected or I spend every night alone, I pretend like I'm in Ireland where the Irish bagpipes play. Smell the grass as a rainstorm is ending. People smile while I stroll past their farms with a red-headed sailor named Brendan. And we dance without moving our arms. Listen to me, okay? At a bar once I met this guy, Dewey. And he bought me like 14 beers. And he told me that he was so I lived with him 10 years. If I squinted, he looked like my savior. Through my boozy delusional fog. But he dumped me for some slut named Kayla. Took my trailer and took my dog. But if I say no, how to love you. You embrace in the misty Irish breeze. And if your Irish boy tires of you, you're allowed to shoot him in the knees. Say, you look like that poster for Ireland. Long blonde hair and that sweet sunny face. Oh no, wait, that's the poster for Sweden. Oh, screw it. I'll never see either place. The girl slid as you has a future. You have hope as each new day dawns. Girls like you always get to see Ireland. Give my love to the leprechauns.
Oh, it just sounds like this madness.
Her man, and there's no hope for the rest of us.
Oh, thank you so much for talking me off the list.
much, Paulette. You have no idea how bad I needed this.
Oh, now you go and you fight for him, okay, sweetie?
The eyes see nothing, no one. They keep fighting till everyone's dead. Not sure where this metaphor's going. I just felt like it had to be said. There's a guy at that party who loves you. Something most of us only dream of. You go out there and you get some Ireland. The country of whiskey and love.
Shake things up?
Yeah, but why couldn't you have worn this when we were going out?
Because I guess you never asked.
Which will now rank as the greatest regret of my life. You know, I still can't even believe you're here. Back at UCLA, never would have guessed it. You know, sometimes I miss the old days. Those party senior year, I thought we ruled the world.
You funneled all that beer, I held your head while you hurled.
We were like gods back then, walking among common men. Tell me why it can't be that way again.
Dreams will just disappear. We can keep on dreaming them here.
What?
My senior year, what's funner? You got your future up ahead.
Yes, I do.
What if I'm sitting there too?
But I'm not following you.
I'm here because I understand.
I'm sure I understand.
I'm here because I'm serious.
Yeah, right. You look real serious.
Order, don't forget that I got into this school too. And now we're both here studying law together. Maybe we can both get Callahan's internship and work together.
Wait a second. L. You get kicked out of class almost every day. You don't actually think you have a chance of getting Callahan's internship, do you?
Of course.
Everyone in the class wants that internship. Nobody more than me. It's a guaranteed career. You're practically a partner before you even have a job offer.
Elle, you're looking fluffy. As usual.
Thanks, Vivian. And thanks for the great tip on the costume party. I see you came as last year's sample sale.
Okay. Elle, you have to ace his course in order to get that internship. And he isn't called C-minus Callahan for nothing.
Warner, I am completely cognizant of both of those facts.
You're not going to make it through the semester
let alone get Callahan's internship. Even if you keep going and going and going. Face it, buddy. One of these things is not like the other. Someday we'll nominate Supreme Court justices and you'll tan. Run home, Belle. And change out of your skank costume. Really? Is that what you see, Vivian? How unfortunate. Because I am Gloria Steinem, circa 1963, researching her feminist manifesto. I was a playboy bunny. Are you actually calling Gloria Steinem a skank?
Who's calling Gloria Steinem a skank?
She is.
School. That's the weirdest reason I have.
Well, then why'd you come?
Okay. I grew up in the Roxbury slums. My mom in a series of bums. Guess you showed me all the ways a man can fail. I got through law school by busting my chaps. Got two jobs in addition to class. So forgive me for not weeping at your tail.
Well, excuse me, just because you've got a chip on your shoulder.
You know what? You're absolutely right. There's a chip on my shoulder, and it's big as a boulder. With a chance I've been given, I gotta be driven as hell. I'm so close I can taste it, so I'm not gonna waste it. Yeah, I got a chip on my shoulder. You might want to get one as well.
I'm sorry, but that sounds highly negative. Wait, two jobs plus law school? How did you do it?
Well, I don't go to parties a lot. Not good use of the time that I got. Can't spend hours doing my hair and staying in shape.
I don't spend hours.
But I know it'll all be worthwhile when I win my first lucrative trial and buy my mom that great big house out on the Cape.
Oh, that's so sweet.
No, that's the chip on my shoulder. I hugged my mom and told her, with the chance I've been given, I gotta be driven as hell. Though I can't take today off, I just think of the payoff. You need a chip on your shoulder, little miss, what's comma L.
I just need to prove to everyone that I'm serious.
What you need is to get to work.
Make yourself at home.
Hello, Kitty. You drink a lot of Red Bulls, don't you?
They give me energy!
So I can stay up late studying?
What?
I said study. You do study, don't you? Where are those law books at?
They're under the...
Under the...
The pile of...
Pile of?
There. There, here somewhere.
You know... This bandy's real picturesque, but it started its life as a desk. Clear it off and find some room for books instead.
Hey, what are you doing?
Can you live without this? Can you live without that? So I don't know what this is.
It's for hair.
Wear a hat. Spend some time improving what's inside your head. House, put in store and sell on eBay, leave it behind. House, were you angry? Good, so get angry. You may find the chip on your shoulder. Ooh, the room just got colder.
Hey.
But the chance you've been given, why are you not driven as hell? There's just no way around it. You gotta plow through till you
found it.
Been bringing it hard, I can tell.
It's a gift to be simple, tis a gift to be free.
Bye, Warner. Happy Thanksgiving. Say hi to your mom and dad for me. And Grandma Lucy.
Define malaprohibitum.
Malaprohibitum is...
an act prohibited by...
an act prohibited by law. Like jaywalking, chewing gum in Singapore.
Therefore, malamints say...
it's an act that's evil in itself. Assault, murder, license after Labor Day.
Good. Where are you going?
Home, of course. Thanksgiving break, remember?
Interesting.
What?
Well, I predict you'll probably pass.
Yes.
In the bottom percent of your class.
What?
If you're going for mediocre, you've done great.
Hey, that's not fair.
Like they laughed at me, like they laughed at you. We can't win if we don't fall through. My time pension, your vacation plans can wait.
You always have to be right. Thank you. You're so sweet.
It's a real time saver. Shampoo and conditioner in one.
Oh! You are smart enough to save me.
Hey, Elle, you seen Viv? I've been looking for her everywhere.
Yeah. I mean, no.
Great. It was a flight.
Walks through the door, your IQ goes down to 40, maybe less.
Huh?
That was hardly my business to say. Could it be the real thing in your way? Is the very guy you're trying to impress?
Yes. I've been smiling and sweet, thoroughly beat, blowing my chance. Let's not chase it away. Let's face it and say, hey, come, let's dance. This chip on my shoulder makes me stronger and bolder. No more whining or waving. I am reclaiming my pride. Grab that book and let's do this. Instead of doodling hard, go through this. Now there's a chip on my shoulder. Let's see him knock it aside. Tell yourself new. Show him that you're no fool. Tell yourself new. Go back to school with a big chip on your shoulder.
Latimer was not stalking. He was clearly within his rights to ask for visitation. Russell, be so.
Russell was known to the mother, while Latimer was just another anonymous sperm.
Well, yes, but without Mr. Latimer's sperm, the child in question would not exist.
Now you're thinking like a lawyer. Yes, Miss Woods.
Mr. Huntington makes an excellent point, but did the defendant keep a log of every sperm emission made throughout his life?
Interesting. Why do you ask?
Well, if the defendant didn't attempt to contact every sexual encounter to find if a child resulted in those unions, he has no parental claim over this child whatsoever. Why now? Why this sperm?
I see your point.
And by Mr. Huntington's standard, all masturbatory emissions where the sperm is clearly not seeking an egg could be called reckless abandonment.
Miss Woods, you just won your case.
Oh my God!
Go home!
You just won that case!
Excellent work today. I assume you're applying for my internship, correct?
I am one step ahead of you. And thanks in advance for your consideration.
Dear God, it's sent.
Great.
months ago I would have recycled this, but now make sure it's on file.
Guess she got a chip on her shoulder. Maybe some wise man told her. But the chance we've been given, we gotta be driven as hell. She was something to see there. I'm just happy I can be there. First big test and she tasted. She said what she could taste it. She got a chip on her shoulder. Yes, you never can tell.
This time I've lived to respect my mind, and at last you find you can love me again. And I have turned my whole world upside down, trying not to let you go. Watching you walk away is like a fatal blow.
What?
Is that my name up on that list? Does someone know that I exist? Is this a mistake? Am I even awake? Pitch me down and make sure. That is my name in black and white. I must be doing something right, 'cause I feel so much better than before.
Warner,
sorry I've been a pest, but I guess my best was not working with you. But I think I found the cure, and I still look forward to working with you.
Wait, working with who?
Hey, remember when we spent spring break in the hotel every night? You said nothing else could ever feel so right. Well, this night, seeing my name up on that list, that be the first time that we kissed. You thought I was up, but I think that somebody's treasure was gone. Seeing my name in black and white, I can love with you all night. No way, you feel so much better. Hello, much better. Much better. 'Cause I am so much better than you could. Maybe she's what you prefer, but hey, last year I was her. Maybe you will change your mind, that you might look up to find I've gone on to better things, better jobs, or bigger rings. I ain't got the time to cry. How you been?